In this component of the fx-9860GII overview, we will be focusing our attention on the statistics icon. You can either highlight it and press execute, or you can press the shortcut key 2 to open statistics. You will find yourself in the list editor. When you enter values, be sure to press execute after each value in order to store it properly. Pressing right or left will move to alternate lists. And there's a really nice feature. If you are unaware of it, you should definitely know that it exists. You can use a formula to apply some kind of a function to an existing list and store it into another list. For instance, if I want to store in list 2 the square of all values in list 1, I can highlight list 2 at the top, and I basically want to tell it to store everything in list 1 only squared. So to do that, we first need the keyword list, which we find right above the number 1. So shift and 1. So list 1 squared. And when I press execute, there you have it. You can do pretty much any computation, multiplying, dividing, adding, subtracting lists, whatever. Sometimes that can really come in handy. Hopefully by now you've seen our menus previously, the soft menu at the bottom of the screen, but just in case you have not, I'll remind you that each of these menus corresponds to the function key below it. So if I want to take a closer look at the graph menu, I would just press F1. You'll see that there are 3 built-in graphs in statistics, graph 1, 2, and 3, so you can graph any of these separately. Or if you use the select feature here at F4, you can actually graph multiple at the same time. You can turn them on and off and graph, you know, 1 and 2 or 1, 2 and 3 all at the same time. I'll press exit to back up, and I'll show you a little more closely the setup menu here. So F6 to set or to adjust the settings. Currently, by default, they're all set to scatter plot, so stat graph 1 is set to scatter plot. If I move the cursor down there, you can see that I can change it from scatter plot to NP plot to pie chart. For more options, I'll press F6. You have histogram, box and whisker plot, bar. These other ones are a little less common. We even have some regression plotting going on here. But these are the most common ones, this first menu and the second menu. Once you've picked something like scatterplot, you can tell it what lists to use. It will usually default to list 1 and 2, but you can adjust that. If you have a frequency list, you can also set that up, and you can adjust the mark type. Now what if I want to adjust stat graph 2? I would move to the top to highlight this, and then I would press F2. To change the setting window to StatGraph 2 settings, and you can adjust these. Likewise for StatGraph 3. Pressing exit brings me back here, and if I want a scatter plot, I believe it was already set up for graph 1, so there you have it. Once you do such a plot, it becomes very convenient to compute a regression if you so desire. You'll use the calc menu, F1. So I already know this is going to be quadratic, but let's just say it looks a little linear to me and I'm not aware. I would grab X here by pressing F2, and you have 2 formats. It really just depends on your preference of coefficient. I'll pick AX plus B, and we have an A, B value, and our coefficient correlation, our correlation coefficient. If you wish to save these numbers, these are not particularly difficult to remember, but if you had a complicated set of regression coefficients, you can copy them nicely and easily by pressing F5, by picking your desired function location, and by pressing execute. There is no notification that it saved, but it did save to that location. In fact, I can show you by leaving menu, going to our graph icon by pressing 5, and there you see my regression equation waiting for me. Pressing menu and 2 will take me back to statistics. And I'll go back to graph 1. I'll again calculate my regression. J- just because I want to show you how to draw it here by pressing F6, and you'll see it fills it right in. You can continue to do regressions if you wish, or you can press exit to leave that. You can also define a graph, which is not a whole lot different than leaving to go to the graph icon. From here, you can graph that existing function. You're not going to see anything particularly different. It's really if you want to define other graphs, maybe if you want to try to fit a line of best fit by eye. Pressing exit again a couple times brings us back to you can calculate regressions. Again, we would recommend you probably graph first. It doesn't generally make sense to computer regression until you have a sense of what the data looks like. You have statistical tests here. So if I press F3, you have most of the tests you're likely to want, unless you're doing high-end statistics, at which point you're probably going to have a statistical software package installed on a computer somewhere. Really quickly, let's do a t-test. Let's say a one sample t-test. You can use a data list, but I'm going to deal with summarized variables. Let's go with a two-tailed. Let's say our null hypothesis is a mean of 50. Our sample mean is 45. Our sample standard deviation, let's make it 20. And let's say we have 50 data points. And if I move down one more, you could just press execute already in order to calculate our probabilities, but I really like to draw it just to show you that you get a nice shaded bell curve here, and then from here you can find your t-statistic or your p-value. So a p-value of slightly more than 8%. Pressing exit brings us back here where you can go up and edit your values. I think this is a particularly nice feature if you're going to be doing numerous t-tests. It's a nice time saver. Pressing exit gets us back. And again, in the test menu, we have access to z-tests, 1 and 2 sample, 1 and 2 proportion, t-tests, 1 and 2 sample, and a regression test. Chi-squared, goodness of fit and two-way, f-tests, and ANOVA. Pressing exit. We'll also take a quick look at the intervals available to us, z and t intervals. Again, 1 and 2 sample, 1 and 2 proportion, and t. And distributions. Normal, t, chi, f, binomial, Poisson, geometric, and hypergeometric, all available to you. I'll open up a binomial distribution quickly. We have binomial PDF and CDF and inverse in this case. So let's take a look at a binomial CDF. Again, I'd rather not use a list, but you can use a list of data, or you can use summary variables. Let's say I want to take a look at the chances of guessing 3 or less, 3 out of 4. On a multiple choice, let's say a true or false quiz, probability would be 0.5. So if I want my probability of getting 3 or less correct, press execute, and there's my probability of getting 3 or less correct out of 4 questions on a true or false quiz. Pressing exit a few more times, let's see what else we have. You can delete all. This is pretty useful if I want to clear out an entire list. As long as the cursor is in that list and I hit delete all and F1 for yes, you'll see that list clears out. You need to do this for each list. You can insert values and delete, etc., but it's really pretty easy to just highlight and press the delete key to delete if you wish. Let's see, and tool. You can sort as well or jump to the top and bottom of a list if you wish. So that ends our overview of the statistics mode. Hope you found something useful in there, and thank you for joining us.